just fine.
Steady on.
Drink fine. Right. That'll be all.
Shove it.
everyone will remember Peter Needham. Peter the Strong. Peter the Com...
Thank you. suit!
Hey!
What do you think you're doing?
Don't pull any punches!
I'm free!
Now, where were we?
Something
happening. What's that?
Someone get me out of here!
Good. Thank you. One less building burned to ashes.
Who's a good horse? You are. Keep moving.
I hear you've dealt with Mr. Lynch on your own terms. Now all that stands between you and the Strand are his ever-loyal cronies. Good luck.
This borough belongs to us! Rooks! Rooks! It's time to fight!
Just try to stop me.
Jacob and Evie Fry. And as of this moment, you all work for us.
Something to give you.
That really isn't necessary.
More gifts? You spoil me, Greenie.
Templar numbers are dwindling, and I hate to admit it, but the Rooks are thriving.
Did you hear that, Evie? Thriving.
Your time in London has been well spent. I am proud of you.
Freddy, I hardly recognized you in your police togs.
You certainly scrub up well.
I thank you for your help in collecting these bounties. I am impressed with all you have accomplished. And I wish you luck with your future endeavors.
There's any, some sort of scuffle over there.
Oh, it's the latest news.
I didn't know you had a twin sister, Mr. Fry.
Evie Fry, sir. It's a pleasure.
Usually I would reciprocate the sentiment, Miss Fry, but today I'm afraid nothing will bring me pleasure.
What's troubling you, sir?
I am used to people challenging my ideas. In fact, I live for it, the cut and thrust of spirited debate. Lately, however, attacks against my reputation have taken a darker turn. Threats of violence against my person and against my colleagues. I do not wish anyone to be hurt because of my research.
You helped me with steric syrup. I am in your debt.
We help each other, sir.
My brother and I will make sure that you can continue your work in peace.
What do you know of bones?
I know how much pressure it takes to shatter, snap, or splinter one.
Perhaps it would be simpler if I just explained the situation. A few days ago, a German colleague, Dr. Schwartz, sent me a telegram. He informed me he was on his way to London to deliver a very important fossil, you see. In fact, he should arrive at Charing Cross any moment now. Would you ensure no harm comes to him?
I'll bring Dr. Schwartz and that fossil to you, Mr. Darwin.
Splendid. But please do be careful.
meaning of this?
I'm collecting you and your precious cargo for our friend Mr. Darwin. Just act naturally.
Right. So, how is your father? By which I mean my dear brother Frank, with whom I grew up, of course. Oh, splendid!
The German doctor supposed to look like
anyway. I'll do my best not to call attention to how remiss he was in forgetting to warn me about the delicate situation which brings me here today. I will surely
Stay
die
back,
without
doctor.
Your protection. Oh, splendid! Wonderful to hear! I'll do my best not to call attention to how remiss he was in forgetting to warn me about the delicate situation which brings me here today.
What's all that?
What's a German doctor supposed to?
It is not safe to travel alone. Take me with you.
Dr. Schwartz?
Never got on the train.
Throw everything you have at him! He can't defeat the wall! I'll fill him with holes! I'll put another hole in his head!
Now to take this fossil to Darwin.
My heart hasn't stopped pounding. You have it? Wonderful. But where is Dr. Schwartz?
Most likely dead, I'm afraid. He never left Germany. At least I managed to get the fossil back.
Dear Lord, I should tell you, I was recently approached by men who sought to purchase all my research on the condition I work only for them. Obviously, I refused. Scientific knowledge cannot be bought. It belongs to everyone. Let these villains do their worst.
Atta girl. That's the way.
Easy now.
Walk on, girl. Who's a good horse? You are. You're doing fine, girl.
My young friend, how good it is to see you.
Fortunate, really. It would appear a highly toxic plant, which has the extraordinary effect of making people quite delirious, has been found in this very park. Yet, as far as modern science is aware, no such plant exists. I fear the good people of London might be in danger. Will you investigate?
That's no ordinary plant. Feels like I'm in an opium den. Oh, what's happening to me? There you go. Hello. Footprints. Might lead me to the culprit.
Do you travel much, then?
That's a girl. Steady on. Thank you.
Mr. Darwin will know what to do with this. Who's a good horse? You are. That's the way.
Well done. But you don't seem quite sure, if I may say so.
It's just as I suspected. Those noxious fumes are not being released from the flowers, but from the pots. There must be something in there.
Or gone, girl.
An hallucinogenic concoction of some kind. Not unlike the soothing syrup, I should think. We must dispose of it. And quickly, I believe, my young friend, that I might know just the place. Who would want to poison the population of London? Who could devise such a nefarious plan? Obviously, it can't be Dr. Elliotson. So who can it be? I'm afraid, my young friend, that some of your enemies want their toxin returned to them. Might I suggest you position our carriage directly in front of theirs? I believe the fumes will impair their ability to drive.
Doing fine, good.
Indeed. Now, we must hurry and destroy our cargo. We're almost there.